Hello students, we shall now find the crossing number of Petersen graph. Now this is a Petersen graph with 10 vertices. There are too many crossings. We could see that the Petersen graph is a non-planar graph with too many crossings. So we have a crossing here, 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 here and here. So now we shall try to remove these crossings by redrawing this graph into a plane. So first what we shall do is we shall draw the outer cycle first, that is the cycle v1 v2 v3 v4 v5 v1. After drawing the outer cycle, now we shall draw the graph which is inside the outer cycle. So now we could see that there is an edge between V2 and V7. So we can draw that first. So this edge will become V2 to V7. And there is an edge between V5 and V10. So that we can draw in this way. So this is V7. This is V10. Now we could also see that there is an edge between V7 and V10. So we could draw that edge. So far there is no crossing. Now, there is a vertex V6 here. Now, if we draw the vertex V6 here, when we draw the edge between V6 and V8, there will be a crossing here. So, in order to avoid it, instead of drawing V6 here, we can draw here. We can keep the vertex V6 here so that when we draw the lines, there will be less number of crossings. So, when we replace this vertex V6 from here to here, we could see that both V6 and V7, okay, V6 and V7 have an edge with V9. So there is an edge V6, V9, V7, V9. So what we could do, this V9, if we, instead of keeping the vertex V9 here, we can replace it here. So V9 and the vertex V8, instead of this position, we can replace it to this position, so V8. Now, if we draw the edge V6, V9, V7, V9, we could avoid the crossing when we replace these two vertices. For example, now there is an edge between V6 and V9 and V7 and V9. Similarly, there is an edge between V6 and V8. Okay, and also between V10 and V8. So, because we replaced these two vertices, instead of V8, V9, we replaced it as V9 and V8, and we brought this vertex V6 here, we have avoided those crossings. But we could see that there is an edge between V1 and V6. So when we draw that edge, no other go, we have to cross this line. I mean this edge V7, V10, because there is no other way. So definitely if we bring it in any different way, there will be a crossing. So the minimum number of crossing that we could make here is 1. So V1 and V6 we have drawn. Then after that, we could see that there is an edge between V3 and V8. So V3 and V8. And there is another edge between V4 and V9. So when we draw this edge, there will be a crossing. So we can't make any other path, I mean any other way where we can avoid crossing. So definitely with no other go, we have to take up this crossing. Now if we see, we have drawn all the edges. So after redrawing this graph into a plane, we could see that the Petersen graph has made two crossings. So there are two crossings in Petersen graph. And so therefore the crossing number, so crossing number of the Petersen graph is equal to 2. Hope you have understood this. Thank you.